You ever just have an epiphany? Like a big one, where you go like, you know, ToDoIst doesn't have an Eisenhower matrix and TickTick does, but wait a second. Can't you just make an Eisenhower matrix in ToDoIst? For those of you that don't know, an Eisenhower matrix is what you see here, and it essentially is a breakdown of the different things between what you should do, which you should schedule, what you should delegate, and what you should delete based on its urgency and its importance. It's theorized that Dwight D. Eisenhower created this, and a lot of people find it very useful for being more productive. So why not just use filters in ToDoIst to make it happen? Duh. Okay, so first and foremost, what you're gonna want to do is go to your labels here and add a few things. So as we see, there are four main things that make up this: urgent, not urgent, important, not important. So all you gotta do is do that with filters. So we make urgent, not urgent, important, and then make not important. And then what you'd do from there is go to filters and labels, and then you'd make different filters here while adding them to your favorites, and you can name them a few different things. We can do it, and then Q1, or like do these tasks, something like that. And then all you'd have to do would filter it to at urgent, you'd have to put and here, important. Say I go to my inbox. If I made a very important task, all I'd have to do would be, this is at urgent and at important. And then press enter. Then if we go to here, to quadrant one, it showed both. Now you can group this different thing by things like due date, priority, label, project, which I think would probably be best here, would be due date or project. So we did by due date. It doesn't have a due date. We could do today. And then from there, we can also sort this by due date. So it's like, it's what is urgent and important, but also like what is the closest thing that we need to do time-wise. Or we could obviously do that sorting by due date and then have it be grouped by project too. It's whichever one you're more comfortable with. And then for this, we'd go back to the filters and then do the very same thing and then make a new one, call it schedule it, and then parentheses Q2. And then this would be to put and. But if I made a task that wasn't not urgent and important, it would go to this Q2. And then by the way, if you want to rework what order these are in, all you'd have to do is move the order of the filters over here. And then that works. Like I'm going to remove that from favorites and just have my favorites be the different quadrants. So then if we take this, copy this just for effect, we can change the color here. So I'm going to make it orange for quadrant two, the red for quadrant one. Then I'm gonna make a new one, call it delegated Q3. This one is gonna be at urgent and at not underscore important. Now you gotta make sure if you have multiple link things, it's gonna have an underscore. That's why I wanted to make sure I did that. So if I, for example, captured a new task and made it at urgent and at not important, it's gonna pop up in here. Then we can add this to favorites, back to filters and labels, move this to the bottom here, change whatever color we wanted for it, and then also do the same thing where we can group it by due date, sort it by due date, and the same for this other one. Then lastly, we just make one that's called delete it, where we can put at not underscore urgent and at not underscore important. Then go to filters and labels, move this to the bottom, make sure we have the Q4 here, add it to favorites, and then if we quick added a task at not important, at not urgent, you'd have your four different quadrants right here in your favorites. If you found this helpful and want to see how you can improve your ToDoIst, I actually have a course on ToDoIst that I think you'd all enjoy checking out. I also think you'd enjoy checking out this video on how to improve your productivity even more.